Hello, Americans. Other friends, subscribers around the world. Back again, man. This morning, kind of dark out there, man. Getting ready. I got got my saw pulled over here. We sawed some rounds. Got some here too. Some rounds for just to stock up firewood just in case, dude. The overnight low tonight is like 38 or something. Last night was supposed to be the last. We'll see, man. You know, they're forecasting. You can't believe shit. But later on, man, like 9 days or something out, they're talking overnight low at 29. But that's a long ways away. And these days, you definitely take it one day at a time. First thing when I get up in the morning, man. Oh, yeah, man, still alive. And then second thing, man, is turn on something with power to see if we still have power, or check my phone to make sure we still have internet. Might wake up one morning and you ain't got none of it. Hell, you might not wake up. Man, the way things are going, dude. Woo! You know, now you're hearing about all the, you know, what's been going on, but nuclear war and bombs and biowarfare, and well, that's the stuff that, get back over there, get back on the other side, Daisy, go, good girl, stay over there, knock me off the bridge into the creek, but man, all that stuff going, you know, everything that's going on crazy in the world, man, the stuff. You know, man, I don't want to see it happen, but collapse of the dollar don't scare me. Freaking power going out, or the internet, or freaking all that stuff, that don't scare me. Food shortages don't scare me, but man, you definitely, you know, I've been telling everybody to get prepared for a long time. And, just depends on what happens and how bad it is, really. And everybody, you know, pops off, oh man, I can fish or hunt, you know, and all that. That would be my plan, you know, long term or whatever. The thing with all the food shortage and thing that worries me more than anything is, and I keep hearing, man, and, you know, all these people always pop off. Well, I know this prepper, man. I'll take him out. That's the kind of shit you hear, especially for the city folk. You know, freaking, it's like, hey, why don't you maybe prepare for yourself instead of trying to take somebody else's shit? And I'll tell you one thing about preppers. You know, I never ran around considering myself no prepper or nothing, but I have a lot of friends, Vietnam vet, you know, hillbillies, rednecks, bikers, cowboys, all that, man. I know a lot of people that you could consider them preppers. And I'll tell you what, you know, these hypocritical city folk or whoever, these, you know, I just blow it off when people say it to me, and I hear it all the time about, oh, I'll just take it out. I know this prepper, man, or I know these Mormons, man, or whatever. Thinking that you're just going to go take their shit. Dude, I'll tell you what. If they're stocking up food and stuff, they're probably stocking up guns and shit. And I know places, mine being one of them, that you best be watching for trip wires and cameras and shotguns on wire. You know, booby traps, dude. Oh, Lord, there's a lot of stupid people in this world. And today, man, I'm going to do this wood and everything, but that's one of the things that I got more cameras that I got to put to. Well, actually, I got them on order. They're not in yet. I was gonna buy some when I was down yesterday, but they weren't really what I wanted. You know, and I don't show them on camera and stuff because I don't really think it's any of your business. So that's as easy as that. But I guarantee, man, I'm gonna pay me up a sign when you come through my gate that says, smile, you're on candid camera. Man, we're doing that, and then my whole goal, which is gonna take, you know, 4 acres is a pretty good distance around. First off is going to be the garden area and you know, the perimeter this end of my homestead or whatever. And then we'll work our way down to the salvage yard and stuff like that. But this whole thing's going to be fence, wired, booby-trapped, camered, everything, man. Because I think that, you know, along with it being prepared and everything, or as prepared as you can be in this crazy world, security is top on my list right now. Just because of all the stupid-ass comments you hear from people. Watch yourself. For all these tough guys. So that's my plan today, man. So I'll chat with you a little bit later. We did get our the sprouter in. It's not as big as the last one we had, but I got the old ones around here somewhere. But then the other thing I want to do is probably, I'm just seeing how much you can see on here, but where the canoe and stuff is and the old steel. We're probably gonna clear it, bring back the motor home a little bit till I get the lumber and stuff down at the other end. Cause then I'm gonna put the motorhome over there, but I think I'm gonna do that to back the motorhome up here so that I can get like the power wagon, get it over here so I can put the fuel pump in it. And then that way I can pull my other vehicles up here to work on them. Just the tools are closer to me. And then I'm gonna move. Dude, I got so much going, dude, so much going on. Petrol. We talked about it before, man. We videoed, showed it and everything, man. Vegetable oil for bar oil. Saving the forest if you do. And it works great. Been using it for years. So the Husky has never had nothing but vegetable oil in it. Is a Husqvarna outrules steel by far. Probably gonna get me a new, bigger Husky. I'd never get rid of this one. I love this saw. Mr. Grager. Morning. 7:30. Yeah, it was chilly. Alright, man, so filmed a little bit. What were you doing?
Waving.
Oh, I thought you were waving to somebody on the street.
What are they doing? Barbecue or something?
So. Anyway, man, I was going to film some more throughout the day. Today we had grandbabies. And Haley's still in town, so she's over visiting. Carla. We actually have the whole everybody but Kev around today.
Yeah, and Tim.
Well, and Tim. Tim's working.
Yeah, the spouses work there.
But, so then, man, we finally get through the day. We eat dinner. Going into the evening. And what were we into? Well, the day credits that thing. There's a new movie out, man. Mel Gibson and Rip, or whatever his name. What's his name?
Cole.
Yeah, what's his real name? Is that his real name?
Cole Hauser.
Whatever his name is, man. The dude Rip from Yellowstone and Mel Gibson. In a movie, we got through the credits at the beginning. They did it like they used to do it.
Yeah, the old school.
Old school way. And finally got through the credits. Must have been into it about 3 minutes.
Ring-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling.
And then we get a call from my daughter, and Tim's working. She's got a plug-in that was making noise.
Sizzling and sparking.
Yeah, sizzling and sparking. So I had to turn off the breakers, which turns out it's on the breakers of her computer, her TV, and everything, of course.
Her internet, and that's how she gets telephone services through that box.
So needless to say, when you have kids, the job of mom and dad,
no matter the
is,
age.
Yeah, no matter what age it is, it's never ending. Okay. So headed out there. So then I thought I'd finish off, and then throughout the day, off and on, I'd try to hide out. Try to hide from all the kids and the wife.
You did a great job of it.
Oh, I don't know. I got a lot done today.
Yeah. Well, I did stop Tevin from coming to find you.
Oh, really? What time? Which time? Stop Sissy. Sissy followed me around for hours.
Yeah, she's a little bit harder.
Anyway, so listen to some podcasts, read a little bit, and it's coming, man. Telling you what they're things that I was reading right now. You know, I don't know how much you've heard about the right now. They're talking about cyber attacks. Actually, some has happened to Apple. You know, we're talking about worldwide, so. You know, I was joking. Well, not really joking. Just saying. You know, in the morning when I wake up, dude, I anticipate, man, I check my phone to make sure that we still got internet service. Check, you know, I said, man, I wake up, feel myself, make sure I'm still here. It, man, it sounds funny, but it's not very funny.
It's not
funny at all. It's true. You know, man, with everything, dude, everything from getting nuked to germ warfare to chemical warfare to World War III to
food shortages.
Food shortages, the dollar's collapsing, dude. They're already, man, I don't know how much stuff you read about that, dude. That's been the plan the whole time, you know, and then they got so much shit going on, so then they do so much other shit. That's part of it. Some of it's a smoke screen.
Yeah.
But, dude, man, I still, man, you know, we've been, you know, preppers or prepared our whole lives, but that's, you know, for how long, I don't know, man. And, you know, depending on what the hell happens. So, and right now with the cyber, if they're talking cyber attacks, and man, I need some cooling here, dude. It is
okay,
nice.
It's
67 or some crap today. Is that what I said it was, 67?
No, I thought it was like 64.
It feels about 98. But, just, you know, food and all that, the food shortages, all that stuff's going to come later when people realize with the wheat and all that. But the cyber attacks, man, if they take out, you know, our power, or, I mean, obviously you won't be watching me, man. So it'll be a few, you know, all of us fending for ourselves. And I sure the hell hope you got stuff ready. You know, man. You won't even be able to pump gas, you know, so you should run down and freaking, you know, I try to keep all my, I'll top this thing off just a little bit when we come back from Katie's. I mean, keep your tanks topped off so you can get the hell out if you need to. I've got an appointment on Friday for, they had to order my tires in to get the tires on the exploder. And then all my vehicles have new or really good tires on them. You know, have it, some trade stuff. So, man, go get some cash, dude. You know, man, there's so many people. I know so many people that only carry that plastic card, which is what they're hoping to get us to. But, man, you definitely want to have some cash on hand, silver, gold, you know, friggin' the old coins. Taking it day by day. I ain't trying to freak you out, but I'm gonna have this video scheduled probably for in the morning. So I actually did this last night. And you may not even be seeing it. I mean, that's where we're at, this freaking crazy shit. There's always the chance you'll never see these hillbillies again.
True.
That's true, dude. Man, they might knock it out. I mean, who the hell knows what's going to happen, dude? You might be listening to me on freaking ham radio.
I was gonna say.
That could happen. I used to be in a side band and all that stuff, man. Ham, that's fun. Remember when I used to talk that dude down and it's crazy I could get him. Remember that?
Yeah.
On my side band, I'd get him. Yeah. Only get him a certain time at night, and he was like in Australia, right, or somewhere like that. Yeah, or something. I can't remember where the hell he was.
Hemisphere was lined up.
Yeah, when everything was lined up, I could talk to him. I don't even get to talk to him. And we'd talk every night. That went on for quite a while.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. Anyway, man, all I can really say is I keep telling you, you know, to be prepared. And be prepared for what? I don't know.
Yeah.
Really, none of us do. That's the scary part. So, get your dang house in order and stock up and be locked and loaded and ready to go. Remember to like, subscribe, and share. Might not do any good later, but go ahead and hit that like button and share with your friends. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. Check out the links below, our eBay. I mean, dude, we might be trucking our stuff around on the back of our dogs. Good thing we have horses for dogs.
That's funny.
Good Lord willing. And them creeks don't rise.
We'll be back again tomorrow.